Let us consider the example which we looked at when learning Lyapunov's indirect method, the linearization method. Remember that we considered the system x dot equals ax minus x raised to 3, where we only knew that a was a constant, but not its value or its sign. And remember that Lyapunov's indirect method showed that for all negative values of a, so if a is negative, then the origin is locally exponentially stable. And for all positive values of a, the origin is unstable. And that for the particular case when a is zero, then Lyapunov's indirect method was not able to tell whether the origin is stable or not. Let us see whether Lyapunov's direct method can give better results. What I want you to do now is to consider v of x equals 1/2 x squared as the Lyapunov function candidate. The system may be interpreted as a mechanical system where x is the velocity and a nonlinear friction acts on the system. No potential forces act on the system, so the system energy is the kinetic energy, which is 1/2 times the mass m, which is normalized to 1, times v squared. And this is our Lyapunov function candidate. So this is one motivation for this choice of Lyapunov function candidate, looking at the mechanical equivalent of the system. Another motivation is that this is a simple choice of a quadratic Lyapunov function candidate, where P is the identity matrix. And since the dimension of the system is 1, this is the same as 1/2 x squared. So there are several possible motivations for choosing this Lyapunov function candidate. Now pause the video and analyze the stability properties of the equilibrium point at the origin using Lyapunov's direct method. We have chosen a Lyapunov function candidate. The second step is to determine whether this satisfies the conditions for being a Lyapunov function and preferably a strict Lyapunov function for the equilibrium point. The function is clearly continuously differentiable, and thus it satisfies the first condition. The second condition is that the function is positive definite in some domain D about the origin. V evaluated at the origin is clearly zero, and V is strictly positive regardless of the value of x. So V of x is strictly positive for all x that are non-zero. In other words, V is positive definite in the domain D, being the whole state space. The third condition concerns the derivative of V. The time derivative of V is the derivative of V with respect to x, which is x, times the time derivative of x. And by the system equation, this is minus x raised to 4. The derivative of V evaluated at the origin is clearly zero, and the derivative is strictly negative for all other values of x. In other words, the derivative of V is negative definite in the domain D, being the whole state space. Then we can conclude by theorem 4.1, Lyapunov's stability theorem, that the origin is locally asymptotically stable. Note that the conditions for being a strict Lyapunov function are satisfied in the whole state space, in the domain D being the whole state space. One question that then arises is, can we then conclude that the origin is globally asymptotically stable? Not necessarily. Theorem 4.2 gives sufficient conditions for global asymptotic stability, and we see that there is one more condition that needs to be satisfied in order to conclude global asymptotic stability. The Lyapunov function needs to be radially unbounded. So, comparing Theorem 4.2 with Theorem 4.1, note that there are two extra conditions for concluding global asymptotic stability instead of local asymptotic stability. First, the conditions for being a strict Lyapunov function must be satisfied in the whole state space. So, the domain D, where the function is defined and the conditions to be a strict Lyapunov function are satisfied, has to be the whole state space. And secondly, the Lyapunov function needs to be radially unbounded. What does it mean that the function is radially unbounded? A scalar function v of x is radially unbounded, if and only if, when the norm of x goes to infinity, then this implies that also the value of the function goes to infinity. Take our example, v of x equals 1/2 x squared, which is the same as 1/2 times the Euclidean norm of x squared. So clearly, when the norm of x goes to infinity, then v goes to infinity. So v is radially unbounded. And by theorem 4.2, we then have that the origin is globally asymptotically stable. So, why is radial unbounded necessary to conclude global asymptotic stability based on the Lyapunov analysis? For continuously differentiable functions, radial unboundedness implies that all the level surfaces are closed. Remember that the level surfaces were defined by v of x equals c, where c was some constant. When the level surfaces are closed, then this is equivalent to that the set of all states inside or at the boundary of the level surface, which we will call the set omega c. So the set of all states corresponding to values of the function v that are smaller than or equal to zero, this set is bounded. As long as the function is positive definite, the level surfaces will be closed for sufficiently small values of c. So the level surfaces close to the origin are guaranteed to be closed. But further away from the origin, the level surfaces are not necessarily closed if the function v is not radially unbounded. See for instance this example here. This Lyapunov function candidate is clearly positive definite. It is zero at the origin and only at the origin, and everywhere else in the state space it is strictly positive. Being positive definite guarantees that the level surfaces close to the origin are closed. And plotting the level surfaces, we see that for small values of c, the level surfaces are closed, such that the set of all states at the boundary and inside of the level surface is bounded. As c increases though, the level surfaces are no longer bounded. The function v is not radially unbounded, and specifically, the norm of x can go to infinity without v going to infinity. When a function is positive definite, it suffices to see what happens when the norm of x goes to infinity along the x-axis to check radial unboundedness. Say that the norm of x goes to infinity along the x1 axis. So x2 is 0, while x1 goes to infinity. The norm of x then goes to infinity. But as x1 squared becomes very large, it dominates 1, and since x2 is 0, the function v becomes x1 squared divided by x2 squared, which is 1. And we can see this here, that along the x1 axis, the value of v goes to 1, not to infinity. So the norm of x can go to infinity without v necessarily going to infinity, And by definition, V is therefore not radially unbounded. And therefore, not all level surfaces are guaranteed to be closed, and we see that they indeed are not. Why is this problematic with respect to global asymptotic stability? Consider this trajectory here. Along this trajectory, the time derivative of V is strictly negative, meaning that the trajectory intersects level surfaces corresponding to lower and lower C values. But the trajectory does not converge to the equilibrium point at the origin. Although the value of the V function decreases along the trajectory is allowed to slip away from the origin since the level curves are not closed. So, although the value of the V function decreases along the trajectory can slip away in this direction and it does not converge to the origin. In order to guarantee global convergence, this should be shaped as a cup, such that when moving down along the inside of the cup, it is not possible to spill out. And this is exactly what the radial unboundedness criterion says. When the norm of x goes to infinity, then the value of V should go to infinity. So V being positive definite, as in theorem 4.1, is sufficient to guarantee that the level surfaces are closed for small values of C. While radial unboundedness guarantees that the level surfaces are closed regardless of the value of C. And as we saw in the example, if the level surfaces are not closed, then the norm of X may move away from the equilibrium point and go to infinity, even if V is a strictly Lyapunov function. And this is the reason for the second requirement in the Lyapunov theorem for global asymptotic stability.